I am headed down to the Aria for a poker tournament, and that by itself probably doesn't sound too unusual, but this one is a little different. I am heading down for what's known as the WPBT, which stands for World Poker Blogger Tour. And this is a gathering of, interestingly enough, poker bloggers. They get together usually the first part of December here in Las Vegas and have some festivities. This is the first time that I have participated. I actually got started last night. We, you know, this is really serious high-level action. We got together for a $2, $4 mixed game, also over at the Aria. And it was it was a lot of fun. It was goofing around. And, you know, as I gotta say, I tend to just run pretty good in mixed games, which is a good thing because it helps offset my really horrible play at mixed games. And for anybody that was at my table who, you know, was on the wrong end of my sucking out, I do apologize, but, you know, we were just there having a good time, right? So, yeah, so that was fun. It was nice to meet some of the people that I've sort of seen on Twitter and blogs and stuff like that. I'm looking forward to getting a chance to meet some more of them today. They, in addition to the regular tournament issues, there is a team last longer bet, three-player teams. And I have ended up on a team with Kev Math, who is a pretty well-known name if you're out there in the circles of people watching this blog, and also the Black Widow of Poker. So the three of us are going to see, hopefully we can make some combined deep runs and you know, bring home a little return on investment. So that's what I'm doing right now, heading down there and doing more vlogging, obviously, along the way, hopefully getting a chance to talk to some folks and getting them on camera.
So,
up the WPBT tournament. I ended up with 81 people. It was another, you know, kind of long run, but fell short of the money. I was out in 27 out of the 81. Kind of fun. I had actually a pretty good table initially. Was able to build up a lot of chips without really having a lot of hands. Although, you know, I did connect very well with a couple of flops that got me quite a few chips built up. You know, kind of went to a point where I moved to another table, a lot more aggressive, card dead, and then had a sequence of hands involving Grange 95, the cracker blog. And, first hand he shoved under the gun. For probably a little over 10 big blinds. Gets down to me, I'm in middle position. I think I've got three people plus the blinds behind me. And I look down at pocket eights, and I'm like, well, you know, there's a lot of his hands that that I'm flipping with there, but I'd taken a hit, I'd lost a pot. I didn't really feel like that was the spot to flip. And turns out everybody folded to him, and he flips over the hammer, the seven deuce offsuit, and so he took that down. You know, that would have been a spot where I could have gotten money in really good. A few hands later, I raised from middle position with jacks. Gets around to him in the big blind. He shoves. You know, now kind of thinking, okay, well, can't really pull jacks here. Not given the way that he's played, the fact that he'll push wide. And sure enough, he had aces. And so I doubled him up there. That got me short. And from that point on, I was just shoving. Had an interesting hand, open raise, call, and I shove for about 11 blinds there. Doing a little bit of a squeeze with ace jack. Initial raiser thinks, finally calls, and go ahead. And the caller calls, and I'm thinking, well, that's not good. Turns out the initial raiser had ace 10, so I was well ahead of her, but the caller had queens. I couldn't find one of the last two aces, so that was my bust out hand. And I delivered my bounty to Kent. My bounty was a bottle of beer. And so that was the end of the tournament for me, but it was a lot of fun. Still going on, and things are going real well right now. Al can't hang and has a pretty monstrous chip lead, so we'll see what happens with him. So, I didn't get much of a chance to wrap up the WPBT tournament. I talked a little bit down at the Aria about how it went. It was a lot of fun. It really was. That's just a good group of people, and I enjoyed getting to meet the ones that I did meet. And I'm looking forward to having a chance next year to meet some more people and to get to know the folks that I did meet this weekend a little better. One of the traditions that they have, and I talked about it a little bit before, is that you will bring a bounty prize to give to the person who knocks you out of the tournament. And I had gotten a nice craft beer bottle, and gave that to the gentleman who knocked me out. I only knocked out one person, and that's the blogger formerly known as Dr. Choco, now Not Ambrose Pear on Twitter. And this is his bounty. Let me get in so you can see it. So this was it, and it's a guitar pick, and he autographed it for me. It says Dr. C on there, and you know, you might say, wow, a guitar pick, but this is pretty significant to me. Dr. Choco was serving in the Army, was serving over in Iraq. And after he busted me out, and he said, well, I'm going to sign this for you and give you the story to it. The story being that this was a guitar pick that he used when he was serving overseas. And he would take time to teach lessons to the other soldiers that were there. And that's kind of how he'd pass his time. I spent a few years in the military myself, never served overseas. My father was a career military officer and a Vietnam veteran. And, you know, people who take the time to serve their country in that manner. You know, there's plenty of issues with our country, but absolutely no issue with the people who literally, these days, put their lives on the line to do it. And to have this, for me, is just really, really special. I really appreciate his giving it to me, and I am very happy to carry it with me. I'm gonna kind of carry it with me at least a little bit when I play. I don't think I'll put it on the table, but it's good to have it with me. I figure that you know, if there's enough run good to get somebody back intact from a war, that it's okay for me to keep it with me while I'm playing cards. So thank you very much, Dr. Chaco, for your gift. Sorry about the sort of spectacular bad beat that I delivered on to you, but you know, as we know, that's kind of how the game goes sometimes. Otherwise, I'm just, like I said, really looking forward to having a chance to get out there again and get to know these folks more. It's a great little community, and I'm happy to be a small part of it. So this is Missing Flops on Twitter.